Thank you, Carlos. Now, we'd like to go on to the next session, which is basically getting to hear from these community networks with respect to what has happened or what they've been up to in the last 6 months. Before we do that, I would like to invite the ones who were not there at the first summit to actually present to us what they've been doing, and you know, so that we get to know what they're really working on. So, just look at the agenda. Sorry, actually, I have my agenda the other way around, but it's still within the time. So, I would like to invite John Bishi. Are you ready? Good. So we'll start with the ones that were at the first summit, and then we'll go later on hear from the ones who were not there at the first summit. So I'm from Murabinda, which is a community network in Murabinda, Cotton White. Those who were around on the first Sunday, they know a lot about what we are doing. And last year, I presented on what we are doing in the area of ICT training for rural educational professionals and the community, individuals from our community. And this was a result from a paper which we presented on a local university in Zimbabwe about ICT rural training, Murabinda perspective. So I'm going to give a short report on what we are doing and the feedback that we are having and the demands that the community is placing on us. And we are continuously training the teachers, and there is high demand on the need of computers, affordable computers for the teachers and for the schools. And for now, I want to play this short video from one of the senior teachers in Buera, Murabinda, who is actually visually impaired, but he doesn't want to be left out in this digital era. So I'm trying to show you how the community doesn't want to be left out, how everyone needs to be involved and to utilize the computers and to have connection also in the community. So I don't know.
Senior teacher, it must be villagers here are not very friendly to me because they cannot speak to me as I use them. I'm visually impaired and I plead for help if there are such a software or gadgets that can help me perform my duty as a teacher in the e-learning way.
Okay. Yeah. So this was the teacher from a local school who also attended the training workshop, and is quite enthusiastic about these things. And I was quite amazed on how he could master the keyboard, and he is looking forward if we can provide computers that can suit his condition. And we are still trying to find out how best we can also help him. And with the pictures on the screen, is on my left, on your left actually, is a grandma who is trying to write an email to his children from diaspora. For instance, the economy in Zimbabwe is quite bad. A lot of people, they now work outside the country. So there is this continuum which we get from Macha. It's connecting the community so that they have internet access for such parents to be able to communicate with their children outside the country. And on the right, those are training workshops with their local government representative supporting the event that we are doing. So this is continuous, and there is high demand for affordable computers and also ways of connection to schools, government offices, the hospitals, and the community as a whole. I'm also going to talk to you today about what about it. I currently filed for a conference that is taking place in Zambia, multidisciplinary conference in August. This is about e-health in Mashingo, which is another province. So this time around, this is the picture taken from Zambia, actually. we are working with an organization, a health volunteer organization operating in Mashingo. And the head of this organization once worked at Murabinda Mission Hospital. So she knows what we were doing in early 2001 when she was working there. She moved to Zambia, she came back, she's Dr. Erika Fanatik. And now she's working with the organization in Mashingo. And we are expanding into Mashingo province in bringing e-health. Now, what is e-health? We define e-health is a combination of use of electronic communication tools and information technology in health sector, ensuring the right information is provided to the right people at the right place at the right time in a secure manner. So, there's an interesting research that was conducted by Oxford, where they posed the challenges on non-profit-making organizations. And it says development is going digital. Now, what should be the role for this non-profit-making organization with regard to what is happening? And the graph shows that a lot says, yes, development is going digital. NGOs, are they getting left behind by advances in IT? And many, they indicated they agree they are left behind. And Solidarity says, no, we are not left behind. And they engaged us, and we partner with them, Murabinda Works, in trying to bring or to improve the e-health infrastructure for the hospitals that they work with. E-health is on our agenda in Africa, Zimbabwe, and I believe here in Kenya it's no longer the national e-health strategy, but rather the national e-health strategy. So African government recognized information and communication technology instrumental to leapfrog legacy system and practice towards improved cost effectiveness and quality of healthcare. Now, the National Health Strategy for Zimbabwe 2016 to 2017, it says the item with the lowest availability was a computer with the internet or email access. And also, it says the hospital information system needs to be harmonized and fully computerized in all departments. And all those kind of things. And Zimbabwe, currently, the national strategy is work in progress. The national e-health strategy actually is work in progress. And in 2017, this year, Minister of Health and Child Welfare is starting to roll out a national electronic health record system, which is e-first. But everyone, when he comes to the hospital, they are not going to put anything or use any file or any paper to write stuff. But right away, it has to be entered into a system. So development still depends largely on opportunistic networking of people, corporate partners, and funding opportunities. Now, in Masingo, the provincial medical director wrote this letter that you see to Solidarity, assisting to help their partners in improving the hospitals so that they become e-health ready. Because a lot of them, they are not yet e-health ready because they don't have money to buy computers or to afford internet access in such settings. So, which IT developments and thousands of people of all and new opportunities and partners institute with Solidarity that we are working with as Murabinda Works. So what we have been doing this year and the end of last year, we have been involved in infrastructure development for the hospitals by setting up a local area network in this hospital for the administration, for the doctors, and for the school of nurses. And we are engaging also in app development with the local people in Masingo. We have built what we call the e-health lab, where we gather passionate, enthusiastic local programmers to develop custom-based applications that will pilot in Masingo rural hospitals that we work with, that we are in partner with. And one of the applications that we are currently developing, like last Saturday we hosted a hackathon in Masingo, and we want to develop a voucher system that will set up at the hospital. So for the hospital that we have set up a visa connection, local area network, we'll set up a voucher system so that the community, the local people in that community can come and also access emails using that voucher system, and they can charge and also raise money to pay for their connection on their own. So, as I said, Zimbabwe is to roll out EHR. This is the standard local area setup for a rural health center in every rural health center in Zimbabwe, what it needs to be like. So this is a basic clinic in the rural setting. It needs to be connected with a server, a small local area network, and also we need solar panels with batteries and inverters. So this is a structure which was actually rolled out by the Ministry of Health for these rural hospitals to improve their infrastructure to be able to utilize the irrigation system. And this is part of the things that we have been doing. That's an edge computing setup with Ubuntu for Surveyor Mission Hospital. This is the Surveyor School of Nursing. They are now using computers, and we have set up a visa there where they can also strengthen their research in medical. We are also doing remote streaming, remote continuous professional education. For doctors in Zimbabwe, you need to attain 50 points to keep your certification as a doctor, or so that you are given a certificate to practice the next year. So these meetings, they are held in Harare, at the Zimbabwe Medical Association. So we have been discussing with the Zimbabwe Medical Association to live stream the learning activities from Harare to Masvingo, so that doctors can have these CPD points without having to travel all the way to Harare. And we have been doing that using just Skype to stream the live meetings, and we send the presentation via WhatsApp, and it can be shown on the slides also in Masvingo. And also we are streaming the prompting meetings being held by UNICEF in Masvingo as well. So this is the visit setup in Chikombetsi Hospital. This is under Chikombetsi District. And this was the process of testing. It's a simple setup, and we are going to go back and improve this setup by doing a local area network. And this is a doctor. Here he was just showing me the result that he has just received from Lancet Laboratories, which is in Harare, for a patient that he wanted to treat. And I don't know the technical guy if I can also use my phone to just play the recording that is what he said. You have to listen what he said.
Yes, I'm online.
And what did you do right away when you came online?
I got my results from Lancet Laboratories.
So that was something you haven't seen yet?
Yes, that's something good. Yeah, it's good.
All right. You're very happy.
I'm very happy.
All right. Well, thank you very much.
So he was very happy to finally receive the results through mail after immediately setting up the visit. And he was happy that he's now proceeding to make treatment for a 9-year-old boy that he couldn't treat because he hadn't received the results yet. And Chikombetsi is quite in a deep rural. During heavy rainfalls or during rain season, you cannot travel there because of flooding. Like the equipment there, actually it was bought by Solidarity, and we were supposed to set it up in Jaguar, but we couldn't because of the road network. Because of flooding. So, what are we doing? We are assisting in building out e-health infrastructure to partner district in Pikita, Saka, and Chilez. These are districts in Zimbabwe. And we are also engaging into our development and to strengthen e-health knowledge base and capabilities. Thank you.